Figuring out what's underground is a very difficult problem because you can't just look at it. Quite often people will use things like metal detectors, which work great if the thing you're looking for underground is metallic, but that's not always the case, so you can't pick up the caves, for example, of a metal detector.
Gravity's very different as a force, like can't block it, you know, acts over infinite distances. So we pretty much use that to find caves and stuff, just like small variations in the gravitational field.
Any underground structure that you would like to locate could potentially be mapped and monitored through a surface gravity measurement. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to map caves, underground caves, these are limestone caves, by measuring surface gravity.
Right where we are, sort of starting from right about there and going along in this direction, so sort of along these lines, are these underground tunnels that is the dip cave at Wee Jasper here. And so as we've traveled and measured in this direction, sort of down the hill, we've passed over a series of five known caves, where it's sort of cave, rock, cave, rock, cave, rock. And so that's what we're expecting to see from the data today. But we've also done a bit of an exploration around other bits beyond the known existing caves in the hope to try and find some out there as well. I think it would be most exciting if we can sort of find a gravitational anomaly that might indicate that there's a cave that we've measured over that wasn't already known.
There's a lot of archaeological applications of it. There's a tomb that you don't want to disturb or something, but you just want to know, like, is there something here, is there not? There's also potential application for like lava tubes on the moon. So like, there's like these lava tubes on the moon where like lava was flowing through, but it's cooled now. That could be a good place for lunar bases, we're presuming.
Underground structures which are useful and interesting on other planets. So let's say the moon, or let's say Mars. You could imagine having a rover with a sensitive gravimeter that you drive over the surface and you're simply measuring gravity as you go. Now, if there is a cavity, a hole, a cave under the ground, which might be useful for all sorts of purposes, you'd expect to see gravity decrease just as it does here on Earth.
One of the other really cool applications of this technology that I want to see is using it as a measurement for groundwater. So it's not just voids under the ground that you can potentially look for. You could use it to measure the mass change of water in the soil, which for Australia is critically important. So trying to measure groundwater is a very difficult problem. Boreholes are very expensive and they give you like one data point. If we can improve this technology and get it to a point where it's able to do big surveys, we could potentially be tracking our water resource and specifically our groundwater resource a lot more precisely, which would be nice. This is a relative GPS base station receiver, and it receives GPS signals with very high precision, measuring their phase, so it can transmit it to our roving gravimeter unit so that we get precise position and altitude. We can get the precision in altitude and latitude and longitude down to about 10 millimeters. That is very important, especially the altitude measurement. So depending on exactly how far away you are from the center of the Earth, the acceleration due to gravity will actually shift slightly based on that altitude. So we have to know that with very high precision.
We saw that there was actually quite a pronounced dip due to the caves, but like the caves are like 20, 30 meters under the ground. So like if you're like over here and over here, you'd kind of measure the same kind of signal due to it. So it kind of just looks like one big dip instead of like a dip for each cave series. It's kind of a bit limited, but also like you can still see that there's definitely something underneath there and it would need further investigation. We found like this tiny hole just like while we were there, like about this big. And we could even still see that with like the CG6's measurements. We took like a very fine grid over that area and there was like a high resolution image of it. So that kind of suggested that it was quite shallow, like quite close to the surface and like also quite small. With like more work, you can also invert that data and you could make a 3D map of the cave, but you need a lot of constraints for that.
The gravimeter that we're currently using is a commercial instrument, a very, very good commercial instrument, so really the best instrument available. But back in the lab, we're developing a new generation of instruments, which are quantum sensors, which are very, very sensitive, very, very accurate, and very low drift.
The quantum device doesn't drift at all. It's completely locked to these atomic processes. So that's why that makes it good for like a long-term survey.
This is our ultracold atom gravimeter experimental apparatus. So in here we cool atoms down to what we call a Bose-Einstein condensate. So this is a cloud of atoms that is at absolute zero, the coldest temperature you can actually get to. And then we drop these atoms down through the tube you see here, which is an ultra high vacuum chamber. And we use these atoms as they fall as a quantum system to measure gravity with incredibly high precision.
While we develop those devices in the lab, we're beginning to ask the question, well, what really can you do and learn through gravity measurements? And we can say, okay, what we learned from that survey with a classical instrument was we would like at least these specifications on the quantum instrument.
What people want to see, you know, at a first pass is boxes of the same size that we see here, but instead of the inside of that, which is effectively a mass on a spring, we have this cold atom system that we're using as a way to measure gravity. And because of the inherent accuracy of the atoms, basically we don't have to calibrate these sensors anymore, whereas these ones need constant calibration and checking to make sure they're actually measuring the right thing. You know, if we make these sensors smaller and as good as they currently are or better, it's going to open up new technology avenues that haven't been accessible before.
A new generation of quantum sensors that elucidate groundwater movement, that contribute to planetary exploration, that perhaps can be used in industrial settings, mining, responsible mining practices, where you know groundwater flows, you know what the local structures look like, you fold into decision making what is the environmental impact and so on. So understanding some of these ideas where the measurement of gravity may, I hope, be a useful additional tool to a whole lot of other sensors where we can begin to improve information so that we can make good decisions.